Here with boxing trainer Marco Contreras at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. So first of all, Matt, gotta ask you this. You were at the fights, Tim Bradley, Diego Chaves, Benavides against Herrera. What did you think of the fights? Andy Lee, Matt Corbo?
You know, I was surprised with all the outcomes, except for Egas' outcome. I already knew that. But Andy Lee, I thought, you know, he was there to lose with Corbo. I thought Corbo was going to roll through him, but surprise, you know. Andy Lee does have power and surprised Corbo. Benavides, Herrera, I think it was, you know, pretty even fight because Benavides fought 2-3 punches, good crisp punches, and then went into defense mode in the ropes where Herrera had his moments and they both had his moments, so it was pretty even fight. I would have said, you know, Herrera keep the belt because the champion, the Benavides didn't do enough to go get the belt, but it is what it is, you know. That's my opinion from what I saw at ringside. I haven't seen it on TV, which is gives me a different aspect, but from what I saw ringside, I think it was, you know.
Everyone that I talked to have Tim Bradley winning that fight. How was it a draw?
I have no clue. I think I was surprised that Chavez didn't do any fouling. You know, he withheld for the 12 rounds without doing anything dumb or stupid. But you know, I had, you know, Bradley early on control the fight, did better punches. But you know, I don't know. It is what it is. You get some decisions where you question the judges, but it is what it is at the end of the day.
You have a busy schedule coming up in January. January 9th, Ivan Redcatch, very, very talented, undefeated fighter from the Ukraine. Then on the 10th, you have Eric Ruiz against Magdaleno, Jesse Magdaleno. Very exciting fight. Tell me about those two fights that you have.
I have Ivan Redcatch, I think, at the Morongo. He'll be the main event on Showtime.
He's very talented.
Either Showtime or Showbox. I don't know which one will be.
He's the fighter for people that has the Kodo tattoo, in case you wonder who we're talking about.
Yeah, Ivan Redcatch. Congratulations to Ivan. He had his newborn yesterday or the day before.
Oh, awesome.
So his name is Luke. Little Luke. Newborn. Okay. So he'll be ready November 9th at the Morongo. Ivan Redcatch, main event on Showbox. Then we have Eric Ruiz, Jesse Magdaleno. A fight that was supposed to happen in November, but got postponed, pushed back to January 10th. Personal issue with Magdaleno. It'll be a good fight for both fighters, Magdaleno and Ruiz, fighting for the NABF junior title at the Texas station in Vegas, you know. We're going against all the odds, but Eric will be ready.
And then you have a fight after that with Alex Voznik, Ukrainian Olympic winner. He's turned pro now, 3-0, two knockouts, something like that?
He's 4-0.
4-0.
4-0 with 3 KOs. We're going to go fight up in Denver.
Brandon Rios Alvarado.
Brandon Rios Alvarado on the card. He's a very excited fight. Look out for him. Alex the Nail Gvozdik.
Everybody tells me he hits harder than anybody else in his gym. And this is a gym full of big, heavy hitters.
Yeah, I think him and Egas go head-to-head. He said Egas hits pretty hard. They spar, and they're probably two of the hardest hitters or the hardest hitters in the gym.
One sentence on Rios Alvarado 3.
You know, be ready. It'll be a war. Both fighters need it. You know, it's 1-1 right now. So it'll be 1-1. Both coming off, you know, Rio's coming off a win that, you know, it's a win, but on DQ, not the way we all want to win. And, you know, Alvarado comes off defeats. So it'll be, they both have a point to prove on HBO, and the winner keeps moving, and the loser probably falls back. So it'll be an interesting fight. Don't miss it.